If my wife were here, she would tell you that there are certain things that I do that really annoy her. One of which, it's hard to say this on stage, one of which is I cannot sit through a movie. And it's worse with Netflix or Prime. I zoom forward to the end of the movie because I've got to know what happens. People are nodding. Okay, I'm not alone. I like to know how the movie ends. I have an impatience here. Why is that important to me clinically? Well, it's important when I think about comorbidity. Because if I'm seeing that patient with social anxiety disorder or with OCD, I need to know what may be coming next in terms of comorbidity. This is one of those times where it is okay to fast forward, to think about how I might target my screening in terms of specific comorbidities that are going to be more likely in that particular patient. And what were those comorbidities? Well, they were what we would expect, a mood disorder. So knowing that that patient is going to be at higher risk for developing a depressive disorder in particular, and also, remember, the most common comorbidity with an anxiety disorder is another anxiety disorder. And oftentimes, like we talked about with panic disorder, that may require a different treatment approach.